Let's talk about the motorcycle crash bars. Do they really worth it? Well, the answer is yes and no. It really depends from the type of the motorcycle you have and the accident you're involved in. I don't have a simple answer for you guys, but I can tell you what I think. Stay with me. The usual advice will be that if you plan to travel the world, you will definitely need it. In the case of accident, they will protect your motorcycle from the serious damages. This statement could be absolutely right, but also could be totally wrong. Let me explain you why. As you already know, guys, the English language is not my powerful side. Sorry about it. Even if I have a clear idea about the topic I have to talk, sometimes you just get me wrong. That's why, to say something very simple, I have to use a long and detailed description with a lot of pictures just to tell you guys what exactly I think. This case is not going to be different, that's why please be patient and wait. I hope until the end of the video you will have a clear idea what exactly I mean. There are a few types of motorcycle crash bars. Number 1. Sliders. They are usually recommended for sport bikes. They are massive metal cylinders or another shape, usually mounted on the frame or on the engine, and the idea behind is that if you slide down, they will protect the most important parts of your motorcycle untouched, or at least from serial damages. I have seen that they really work well. The main reason to work so well is because they have a large diameter, they are short, usually supported with big bolts, and it is almost impossible to bend it. The second type, much bigger than sliders, are made from pipes, bended pipes actually. They are designed to protect your engine, your radiator or cylinder heads. The most famous, and you probably already seen it, is on GS1200, just to protect the cylinder heads. But of course, there are many different models, sizes and options, almost for any bike. The third type is more likely to be seen and used on adventure bikes. They are designed to protect the engine and also the side of your motorcycle. You can find thousands of pictures and video evidences that they really work well. Actually, there are thousands of models and you can find and choose the one which is suit to you and your motorcycle and of course your wallet, because they are not cheap. There is another one type, in last few years it became more popular, mostly after the new GS1200 Adventure was launched. It is actually the combination between the bottom and the top parts. In some models it's going around the bike, even under your headlights, so the idea behind all of this is to protect your motorcycle from any accident. You can see it on the new Honda Africa Twin and all KTM Adventure models. So guys, I talked so much and said nothing, like a real politic. So the question is still there, do they really work? Is it worth it to spend money for crash bars? Well, the answer is not that simple. If I say yes, they work, then you're gonna ask, okay, but you don't have on your motorcycle, why? If I say they don't work, then many of you will attack me with the evidence that they work, that it's much better to have a crash bars and they will protect you and your bike and so on and so on. Who is right? Everybody is right, because it really depends from the type of the motorcycle you have and the accident you're going to be involved in. For example, on a GS1200 they are absolutely must, because if you go down with your boxer, probably you're gonna break your cylinder heads, but on my bike they are not necessary. And it is not because I am a super profi, I never crash. No, absolutely not. I crash it many times. But my bike crashed pretty well. Actually, nothing really happens. Only the scratches on the tank covers, that's all. As you already know, I spent a lot of time and efforts to shave some weight from my motorcycle. And it will be very stupid to add it back with crash bars. Because some of these crash bars, especially the heaviest one, the biggest one, are weight about 5, 7 to 8, up to 10 kilograms. On the other hand, if I have a GS1200, I will definitely use it, because this is very important to protect the engine. What I will suggest, before you really purchase the desired crash bars, go and see it. Of course, if you have that possibility. Go and see it, how exactly it looks like. What are the mounting points? How heavy it is? Where it's supported? And many more like that. I am sure that you can find more than enough video reviews of any model of the crash bars you want to buy. As you already know, the most famous, the most important part of any crash bar, and of course the weakest point of any crash bar, is the mounting system. It is very important to be mounted properly. I have seen so many poor designs. For example, a few years ago I decided to buy one for my motorcycle. On the pictures and regarding to the description, it was looks absolutely great, was not so big, light, the mounting points were secure, so I ordered one without even seeing it. I thought that it's going to be strong enough to protect the bottom part of the engine and also the radiator in the case I go down. I'm not going to tell you the brand because it is not important. Actually, they have some very good products. But when these crash bars arrived, I was nasty surprised. The pipe was fine, no need to be wider. But the mounting points were so poorly designed that actually I spent more than 2 hours trying to fix it on my bike. I had to remove 50% of the parts around the engine to be able to fix it. And from the moment I made it, from the moment I installed it, I immediately realized that I made a huge mistake. It was obvious that it's not gonna work on the way it was described. It is more likely to make more damages than to provide real protection. The weakest point was that it was supported only on 2 spots, which is mean that if I go down, it will bend immediately because of the weight of the bike. The distance between the actual pipe and my engine cover was just few millimeters. So instead of scratching my tank panels, I can break my oil filter cover, water pump housing, or even break the cooling reservoir. I kept it there for a couple of months. It's not because they provide any kind of protection, no, because I cannot remove it. But next time when I was need to work on that side of the bike, I remove it. Actually, one of the mounting holders is still there, because to remove it completely, I have to take down the whole engine. What I try to say basically is that the crash bars will protect your motorcycle if they are designed and mounted properly. Do you think that this 3mm rail will hold the weight of 250 or 300 kilograms bike? Or this 6mm bolts will not bend when you go down? The laws of physics are clear and you don't have to be a professor to realize that the heaviest bike is, better design and stronger holders you will need. Otherwise, they will protect your motorcycle only if you drop it on the side with no speed. You will need something more solid with at least 3 holding points. Something like this or this. It will be much better if they are on the frame instead of the engine. Then you can be sure that when you hit the ground, the bike will be safe. I will also suggest to buy a proper handlebar, at least 28mm. And also a handguards with the metal frame in. Because it is 100% sure that when you hit the ground, the handlebar will absorb most of the impact energy. And my last advice will be, instead of spending so much money for crash bars or crash protects or whatever you name it, try to improve your riding skills. Or if you cannot on your motorcycle because it's too heavy, change your motorcycle. You will feel significant difference with your riding skills if you just try with lighter bikes. As usual, guys, thank you very much for watching and do not forget to subscribe for a new video every week. Ride safe. Ciao.